So in this video, I'm gonna show you one trick to know if any promotion on Amazon is true, or even better, to get notified when some product reaches the price that you wanna pay. And we're gonna check together the best deals that I could find that are gonna make the quality of your content better or simply make your life easier. E aí, I'm Henry, a Brazilian photographer and filmmaker living in Italy, and in this channel I help you with the tech tools to be creative. If you're watching this video before Black Friday, perfect. There are many deals that you can take advantage right now. But if not, not a problem. There are many tips here and suggestions that you can use at any time. Quick disclaimer, all the products mentioned in this video are gonna be linked in the description below. And if you use them to purchase something, you're gonna be helping the channel, but at no extra cost for you. Now, the first tip for us to begin with is for you to download an extension to Chrome called Camel. It just lives integrated into the browser, and whenever you access any Amazon page, you can just click on the icon and it's gonna show you the history of the price, be it by products shipped by Amazon, by third parties, or even used ones. And in the same window, if you set a price to be alerted about, you're gonna receive an email as soon as the product drops below that price. I've used it in two different ways. The first one is when you identify a product that had already a lower price than the current one. So you know there's a probability that that will happen again, so you can set that price as your alert limit or maybe a little bit higher. And another way of using it that worked a couple of times with me was setting an impossible price for a very expensive item. Sometimes it's a flash deal that it's gonna last just a couple of hours and you're gonna be notified immediately. And sometimes it's a mistake in the price. Alright, after this tip about the plugin, let's go check some deals that I found. The first item is this camera bag, that when I bought it, it felt just stupidly expensive just for a bag. At the time, I had bought online the camera, gear, accessories, lenses, everything, and went just to pick it up in the store, but without buying the backpack online. I wanted to see it first. And when I got there, the one that I wanted, that was much cheaper than this one, didn't fit everything. So I had no choice but to get one of these, and it was one of the best decisions that I took. This backpack has now 5 years, had no problems at all. It fits all of my gear for a day, including camera, 3 lenses, drone, extra batteries. Sometimes I take the gimbal inside it. I take the tripod on the outside. I take some personal items. There's space also for a 13-inch notebook. It has all these compartments inside for you to rearrange the way that you prefer. Also with this small external bag that I usually carry my audio equipment, and a rain cover that proved very useful many times. And anyways, it's rock solid. So it's kind of like it costed until now 9 cents per day, which makes me quite happy. I had no idea it was gonna last this long. Now, if you have more gear than me and you have a strong back, you can also get the 450 version that is slightly bigger and also fits a bigger notebook. But it can get really heavy. Now, these two keep going up and down, so you have to check with the Camel extension when there is a promotion about them. There's a slightly smaller version, that is the 300, that looks really cool, has a similar build structure, a bit less space, but it has a very good price right now. Now, SD cards are something that it's not fun at all to spend your money on, but they are things that have a very high potential of giving you a strong headache. Now, about SD cards, I found two interesting deals. The first one is this bundle with the SD cards from Sony, that I have one of them and it's blazing fast. They're very, very good. And this is a pack with two SD cards of 64 gigabytes and a small case to carry them. Now, if you don't care about the case, with 10 bucks more, you can get two SD cards from Lexer, which is also a very, very good brand, of 128 gigabytes that are probably gonna live on your camera, which is what I do with my A7 III, for example, that has a dual card slot. So I have two SD cards of 128 and mostly I don't ever need to swap them for anything else. They can stand more than 2 hours of 4K recording, so it's much more than I need. Now, if you don't feel like spending that much, and if you like the speed is not that necessary according to your camera, you can also go for these SanDisk SD cards that are also in a very good price right now. I've been using SanDisk for a very long time and I never had any issues with them. Also, these have the, let's say, advantage if you have different devices that will take micro SD cards also. If not, probably it's better to get a normal SD card so that you can ditch the adapter and have one less point of failure. Now, this deal is a little bit more on the expensive side, but it's a very good one considering the original price. The Sony 2470 is an amazing zoom lens for Sony full-frame cameras, and it's the lowest price I have ever seen this lens. It has two main competitors, one from Sigma and one from Tamron, which is the one that I have and that I highly recommend also, and that is also a lot cheaper. Now, if the budget's not a problem and all you care about is the top quality and you want to live inside the Sony ecosystem for the better autofocus and sharpness possible, then I'm going to leave in the description below the links also for the Tamron that I recommend. Now, what if you're looking for a camera properly? And I couldn't find any significant deal on any kind of camera that I would recommend that I've tested before for you guys. But one of the cameras that I have and that I would recommend is the ZV-1, and it has a very good price right now. And many people argue that smartphones can do better than some of these compact cameras, but this line from Sony is very good, and it includes also some functions that you cannot find on a smartphone. So you have the hot shot where you can plug in a flash or maybe an external microphone. You have all the plugs here on the side, even HDMI if you need, and also for microphone. The quality of the sensor and the pictures and the video is higher than any smartphone I've used until now. And the stabilization on this one is amazing. So if you're vlogging, if you're walking around with the camera, this is top quality. I have two issues only with this camera here. One is the battery being so small, it doesn't last much. So the solution is really just to get more batteries. And the other one is if you're filming in 4K, it has a slight crop that is already enough to make the framing not feel right. And for this, there are two solutions. One is using an adapter, like you can see right now, to make the field of view a little bit wider. And the other is just switching from this one to its bigger brother, that is the ZV-E10. It was released a while ago and features interchangeable lenses, but it's of course more expensive. Now, switching topics to audio. And if you're making any kind of content for the web, you're gonna need music, be it commercial products or something for social media. For a year now, I've been using MusicBed, and I highly, highly recommend it. It's a very good platform. They have so many really good songs, but I had just one issue, which was the basic plan did not cover for commercial licensing. You had to purchase songs individually if you wanted to use it in a commercial project. And this week, a more recent platform called Audio is offering a 1-year subscription for $60. I've been recommended it, I've signed up, and now I've been using it for a week or so, and I'm finding that the songs are also very good, despite the catalog being way smaller than the competitors. But for the price, it's definitely worth trying it out. When using a computer, you're gonna be looking at a display the whole time, be it a notebook or a workstation like mine. And saving too much on the display is something that doesn't make any sense at all, especially if you're doing some color-sensitive work like photo or video editing. So far, the deals that I found for displays are modest, but there are some. I'm gonna link them in the description below. And one of the displays that got a small discount right now is the BenQ PD2700U that I've reviewed in this channel before, and you can check the video right here. I'd also recommend the Asus ProArt line, but I couldn't find any good deal on them as of now. Now, I've never been a huge fan of action cams, but recently they've improved a lot. And there's a very good deal on the GoPro Hero 8. We're already at the 10, but the 8 already features very good quality of image and also incredible stabilization. One of its competitors that is a little bit newer is the Insta360 Go 2. You can get both of them for roughly the same price. The advantage of the Insta360 is that it is really, really small and the case recharges it so it lasts a little bit longer than a GoPro battery. But the GoPro in comparison is a little bit bigger but has the displays which make it much easier to use and you could simply buy more batteries. And also regarding image quality, the GoPro has a little bit of an advantage. Now, light solutions. There are many small investments that you can make to improve your home studio or if you're just shooting outside. To be more versatile, I definitely recommend the Aputure MC that you can see hidden right here, just illuminating the background. It can be used like this, just as a practical light, but it could even be used as the key light if you're filming yourself. Sometimes I even use it to replace a flash. Now, if all you need are some practical lights, instead of buying one of those, you can get a kit of smart bulbs. I've been trying different brands and I stuck with these Antella smart bulbs. They are the ones that you can see in the back here right now. The color accuracy for video is not very good, so you cannot count on it to be very precise to the colors if you have a palette of colors, for example. But just for YouTube videos or things in general, they're very practical to use. They connect to your Wi-Fi. You can use their own app to control all of them at the same time, or you can just integrate them all in the Google Home app and use it to control everything. Right now, I have a set of different brands, so I use only the Google Home app to control everything at once. The only problem is that the color not always results the same. So if you choose blue, it's not always gonna be the same tone of blue on all of them. So if it is possible, stick to just one brand. Now, if you're looking for something a little bit more professional that doesn't break the bank, you can get the Godox SL60. It's a very good studio light that doesn't have the price tag of professional lights. It's very well built and in combination with a good softbox, it produces a very soft light like you can see right now. It's just not very practical if you need to take it outside, as it does not use batteries. It has to be always connected to the plug. Alright guys, these were the tips and deals that I had in store for you today. If you know of any other good deal for creatives, please write them in the comment section below to help each other out. And if you don't follow me on Instagram, do so. This way you can see some tips and tricks before the videos come out and also the production of these. Alright, I'll see you in the next one. Ciao, ciao! Yay, thanks so much for watching. I hope the Camo plugin told you that you have some pretty good deals in your hands. And if you feel like watching something else, check this video over here. It's what YouTube is recommending you right now based on your preferences. I have no idea what it is, but it's probably interesting for you. Ciao, ciao!